Okay, so we have seen three ways to transform the variables using a nonlinear transformation, the logarithm, the piecewise linear specification, and the Box-Cox transform. Now we would like to go back to this idea of heterogeneity and to model the fact that the socioeconomic characteristics interact with the attributes of the alternatives. And we will show that it is possible to do it in a nonlinear way as well. I mean, we did it already using a linear transformation. Let's do it now in a nonlinear way. So if you remember, the idea of the interaction is that we would like the beta IN to be individual specific. And the way we presented it before is to say, well, let's make beta IN a function of one of the socioeconomic characteristics. For example, we define beta IN equal beta, a parameter to be estimated, times the income of individual N, so that people with different income will have a different parameter. But we can do it now in a nonlinear way, using the same idea that was used for the Box-Cox transform. We can say, well, let's include an additional parameter lambda, and let's define now beta IN to be equal to beta times income, but raised to the power lambda. And lambda can be interpreted as the marginal modification of beta as a function of income. So actually, the mathematical definition of lambda is the derivative of beta with respect to income, which is normalized. So multiplied by income and divided by beta. You can verify that this is valid. So this extension to the interaction is a nonlinear extension involving a new parameter lambda, which should be estimated from data. Some remarks associated with this specification. As I said, lambda must be estimated from data, and the utility in this case is not linear in parameters anymore. Sometimes because you raise a value of income to a power, this generates numerical issues. So it's usually a good idea to divide income by a reference income, like the mean income in the population or the max income in the population. It does not matter. Select a reference value and divide the actual value of income by this reference income. In this case, when the income of the individual N is the reference income, well, the beta coefficient for this individual is actually the value of beta, which is here. Now you can be creative and combine various socioeconomic characteristics into this specification, but they must be continuous. So typically, the two classical continuous socioeconomic characteristics are income and age. So you can define your individual specific coefficient to be the product of a parameter beta, a term which is related to income, again divided by the reference income and raised to the lambda 1, and the third term, which is the age, divided by the reference age and raised to a power lambda 2. And in this case, you have three parameters to estimate: beta, lambda 1, and lambda 2.